Welcome, Catch fans, to another week of HCW TV. I'm your host, Peter Crockett, and as always, I'm here to bring you all the news and goings-on of HCW Wrestling. You can catch HCW this coming month on Thursday the 2nd of July at Wolverley Arts Fest at Wolverley CV Secondary School, on Saturday the 11th of July at Bromsgrove Carnival, on Friday the 24th of July we're heading to Dinnington, on Sunday July the 26th we're at the Aldridge Arena. So, a few weeks ago, we saw a fired Macho Man Chris Cage make his return to HCW under a mask after he tornado punched the owner of HCW, the Millionaire Mike Cash, after his Continental Blindfold match against the Natural James Blade. The Bearded One would then take his rightful place on commentary for the following few weeks.
Where's my hat? Mike Cash, I told you last week on YouTube that I was gonna be here in Wolverley Sports Social Club. And you just got a tornado punch for your efforts, Mike Cash. So I'm gonna go and sit over there at commentary like I should be. Hey! You come anywhere near me, I'm gonna stick this size 12 boot up your jacksie, you understand me, man? And Cobblepot, you can go find a more perverted costume as well.
Due to these actions, the Millionaire Mike Cash has decreed that the Macho Man Chris Cage has been banned from the Catchatorium for the foreseeable future. However, he has allowed me to choose a member of the paying public to join me on commentary for the next few weeks. Because, after all, he is a philanthropist and an all-round nice guy. Let's take you straight over to the Catchatorium then to see who will be joining me on commentary for the next few weeks. If there is anyone in attendance who would like to come up and do commentary for the next few weeks, I get to choose. If you'd like to, shout up. Anyone? Just a minute, ladies and gentlemen. I think we've got a punter. Ladies and gentlemen. I think we have a commentator to join me. Ladies and gentlemen, a paying member of the public, the Macho Man, Chris Cage. Nice to have you back, brother. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's get this show underway.
That ticket was expensive. Can't believe how much it cost to get in. This better be a good night of action, I can tell you right now, brother.
Okay, the Macho Man thwarts Mike Cash yet again by buying a ticket to the Catchatorium and takes his eligible place on commentary.
If you'd like to book HCW Championship Wrestling at your venue or event, then email us at johnnyrosehcw@yahoo.com or via our Facebook page or website.
Our match this week sees Black Demon attempt to do what no one else in HCW has been able to do, and that is defeat the monster Damian Bane by pinfall or submission. Let's get you straight over to the Catchatorium to see this battle of the powerhouses. As always, your commentary team are myself and the Macho Man Chris Cage. Let's commence some catch.
It'll be interesting to see how the Black Demon fares against Damian Bane. We have seen the Black Demon before. Last time we were here in HCW at Starport for Rumble Mania. A dominating performance then, and also in the TV title tournament. But I don't think he's ever faced a man the size of Damian Bane, or 22 stone of the man. Just driving him into the corner there. Not many people face a man the size of Damian Bayne. I certainly wouldn't want to meet this guy on a dark night or on a light day for that matter. To be honest with you, this guy is big. Oh, but there we see the takedown. The Black Demon. What's he looking for here? Looking for a camel clutch. Surely he's not going to get the big guy in a camel clutch. He's got him stretched back now. All that torque on the back, Petey Crockett.
Indeed, I'm impressed that he's managed to get the big man up. Get him locked in. Boy, see, they're into power and out, Damian Bayne. This can only end badly for the Black Demon. Into the ropes. There, into the top turnbuckle. Oh, and a big snap there, taken down over the top. And boy, is the Black Demon just getting out of the ring.
Peter Crockett, have you ever seen the Black Demon's face? Because rumors backstage are that he's very similar to the Elephant Man. If you look at the shape of his head, a little like an elephant's foot.
Thankfully, the Black Demon does keep his mask on at all times, I think, for that purpose.
Somebody saw him in the fish and chip shop in Starport earlier. He had his mask on. Just a pair of Bermuda shorts and that mask. Terrifying.
Louis did not look impressed in one slightest bit. Cobblepot there just telling the Black Demon that he was going to get... He's going to... Oh! Again, the quickness of the Black Demon. I'm surprised to see the big man leave his feet. Oh, again! Oh, just a one kick, one count kick out there. I think that took him for now, the Demon. Oh, here we go. Oh, there's just a mighty slam to the ground. We saw this last night from Damian Bayne, the Skull Crusher. Reminding Petey Crockett, which wrestler made this crush hold famous? Was that Crush? Crush. We saw this last night on the Bulldog Chris Smith. Little head temper, but unfortunately I don't think we can see the colour of this man's head go. Bulldog had a purple head. He did indeed. He's sweaty and moist. Oh, there's just a powerful clothesline taking the Black Demon down. And again, going back to that Skull Crusher, trying to pop. Just pop his head clean out, pop those brains out of his eyes. Reminiscent of the Mountain. He's fading there. Don't think there's going to be much left in his Black Demon. All that force and pressure being pushed onto. Oh! Black Demon managing to come back. Ducks the clothesline. Oh, there's just a big back elbow. Again, straight back to that Skull Crusher. Cobblepot just looking on, proud of his employer. Oh, Bane's just caught him there, sends him off, ducks the clothesline. I think Black Demon managed to counter that. There's a kick over two. I wasn't sure whether Black Demon managed to counter that or whether he got planted, but by the looks of it, he managed to get something and drop the Damian Bayne on his head. Petey Crockett, have you been drinking? Black Demon now off the top rope. Cross body. Uh-oh, just caught. Nightfall! There It's all over.
A huge battle between the two powerhouses, and even with his pimped up manager, Damian Bayn still manages to hit Nightfall for the 1-2-3.
For everything HCW, find us on Facebook at HCW Pro Wrestling or New Page, on our website www.hcwwrestling.com, and on YouTube at HCW Wrestling UK.
Join us next week where we have the highly anticipated light heavyweight title match between the Natural James Blade and Dan Stryker. Be interesting to see, will Dan Stryker still prove that he is the dominant light heavyweight champion in HCW, or will James Blade manage to pull an upset? Will he be able to remain focused with the love of his life, Sandy Beach, at ringside? Who knows? You'll have to tune in to find out. For a Mike Cash joint, I've been your host, Peter Crockett. Till next time, Catch fans.